Developing this morning, former South Carolina governor and ambassador to the United Nations, Nikki Haley, made something of a break, a pretty significant break, with the former president of the United States. She told Politico's Tim Alberta, quote, "He's not going to run for federal office again. I don't think he's going to be in the picture. I don't think he can. He's fallen so far. We need to acknowledge he let us down. He went down a path he shouldn't have, and we shouldn't have followed him, and we shouldn't have listened to him, and we can't let that ever happen again." Joining me now is Democratic Majority Whip and the Dean of the South Carolina delegation, Jim Clyburn. Congressman, thanks so much for being with us. And I'm just wondering what you think of what your former governor, Nikki Haley, said. How much weight do you put in it?
Well, first of all, thank you very much for having me. Well, you know, we often say down here in the South, better late than never. And I suspect that that may apply here. But I think you're right this morning. When you said that this is an incident of Nikki Haley breaking with Nikki Haley. Just 2 or 3 weeks ago, she was admonishing us to leave the man alone. Now she's saying we shouldn't have followed him. Well, that's all we've been saying all the time. This man does not deserve to be followed. Now, we'll have to wait and see whether or not this break means anything.
What does it tell you about the potential for other Republicans or other people who have been supporters of the president to turn their backs on him, at least politically, even after the impeachment trial?
Well, you know, I watched very intently, especially on yesterday, as the House managers closed their remarks. They were brilliant all week. They have allowed of the American people to see exactly who and what Donald Trump is. This, to me, is a big contribution to the Republican Party. I don't see how they could possibly not take this opportunity to free themselves of the yoke that this man is around their necks. And so I don't know that they'll do it. I suspect that they'll give him a mulligan, as they did before, but Donald Trump knows very well the next mulligan he gets is going to have to be on the golf course, because they're waiting for him down in Fulton County, Georgia, as well as up in New York. I don't think he's going to escape this. This is just the beginning.